Well, voting is delayed in parts of Cotabato as police personnel take over as the city's electoral board members. Acting COMELEC spokesperson Rex Laudianco says some teachers had backed out from facilitating the elections due to perceived threats to their safety.
Wala naman pong actually na nasaktan doon sa mga electoral boards or na threatened, but they perceived threats to their persons. Kaya po they manifested na po to our officials that they opted not to serve. The Election Service Reform Act specifically allows and provides for PNP personnel to serve as electoral boards kapag ka po merong ganito, matters of security and matters of emergency.
Meanwhile, the COMELEC assured residents of Bukidnon, the Energy Department is already working to address the on and off electricity in the province.
We have Plan B. We have the batteries. Okay? What we have, Plan C, we also have generators. So everything else failed pagdating sa energy. Same standard contingency measure, tuloy po ang botohan. Hindi po hihinto dahil pwede naman pong bumoto sa pamagitan lamang ng balota. And then ibabatch feed po natin sila under the watch of the watchers and the accredited citizens arm.
All business groups have a long wish list of policies and programs for the next administration, which they believe will benefit the Philippine economy. Warren de Guzman gives us a look.
The business community has a long wish list for government. In fact, the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry, the largest organization of privately owned businesses in the Philippines, has been submitting a wish list to the Duterte administration since 2016 under the Sulong Pilipinas Open Dialogue Initiative. Former PCCI President Bing Limhoco says there are a lot of problems which the public and private sectors must solve together.
We hope that the incoming administration will be able to listen, connect, and engage with relevant personalities, groups, and industries in crafting a sensible and doable roadmap for economic growth.
Many of the wish list items are not new, including the wish for more infrastructure, which remains insufficient in spite of an 8 trillion peso build infrastructure initiative. Some projects were completed, while some are still being built. Some of the delays were caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, which effectively took away 2 years from the administration. However, veteran transportation planner Engineer Rene Santiago, who has worked on 4 National Capital Region infrastructure programs going all the way back to 1977, says the problem is there is no follow-through. He even says build won't push forward under the next administration because of budget constraints caused by COVID. But he also says there are other more entrenched problems in Congress.
The mind of the congressman is to get one, a piece of the action for everyone that is not planning.
That brings us to the wish list compiled by the Strat-based ADR Institute through a survey with partner Pulse Asia. One of the questions in the survey asks respondents what they are looking for in their elected officials.
Untarnished character. Untarnished reputation, not corrupt. That's a good value that to look for in a candidate. Has a clear program or platform of action, very important. Except to put substance in campaigns. Candidate that will offer us programs, clear policy initiatives. And has extensive experience in government. Because what's the use of good statements, slogans, if there's no good track record?
Whoever is elected will inherit a myriad of problems. Inflation is rising at 4.9% in April, with no end in sight for the geopolitical tensions in Europe, which are causing waves in commodities markets. Employment is improving, with unemployment hitting a new pandemic-era low of 5.8% in March. But more and more workers are unsatisfied with their pay. There were 2.87 million unemployed and 7.42 million underemployed Filipinos that month. Export growth has slowed significantly to just 5.9% in March from a 15.8% expansion the month before. Imports are also ballooning as the Philippines pays more for oil shipments, forcing the trade deficit to $5 billion for the month, up 81.4% year-on-year. The Philippine economy has yet to recover to its pre-pandemic growth trajectory in spite of sharp improvements in activity with the easing of mobility restrictions.